Hello and welcome back to the next installment of the Road to Nijmegen campaign and tactical overview time, which I think is needed because this battle kind of expanded in size a bit, and I think the last video might have left some people, including myself, somewhat confused. Okay, so this is what's going on, roughly. So I'm advancing on two sides of the road. North and south. And, yeah, in the south we have A Company, which is pretty depleted, already has been at the beginning of the scenario. It's supported by a few tanks here, and they got this objective here, and that's where I wanted to stop, basically, because I don't have to get all the objectives to score victory. So, I secured this. And then several things happened. For one thing, the Germans got reinforced continuously by Jagdpanzer IVs, which showed up in various places suddenly, and including here. So I knocked out one over here first, and then a second one here. But between that, suddenly, while I was, you know, encamped at this hedge line, a platoon of SS troops that apparently were with the Jagdpanzers, I'm gonna guess, just ran out here and got completely slaughtered. I don't know why. I assume this is some kind of scripted event, but it might have been triggered wrong. I don't know, because it doesn't make a lot of sense. But yeah, they got completely slaughtered. I've never seen anything like it. Not even on the Russian front. So now I have the tank. I pushed it up to this hatch line here, took out another Jagdpanzer. And now there's still some riffraff left here, including that anti-aircraft gun that took out one of our armored cars earlier. And apparently heavy machine guns. One sec. Fallschirmjäger or SS? Looks like normal Wehrmacht or maybe SS, not Fallschirmjäger. Anyway, so that's the southern flank, A Company flank. Considering the situation, I am kind of thinking about maybe pushing for this one as well. Like putting an infantry platoon into here. However, as I said before, A Company is pretty depleted. I have only one really good platoon left in here, these guys. And even they have had casualties, but relatively light ones, and they still have their Bren guns. This one is still intact, actually. They must be having a charmed life. But generally speaking, and as you can see, even these guys are cautious right now. Cautious, yeah, they're burned out, right? I don't really want to do much with them anymore. So, I'm not sure. For now, I will keep them here, kill these guys. Maybe I will push into here later. But for now, let's go to the northern flank, where we have B Company, which is split into this firing section here with normal infantry and heavy machine guns and mortars. And this assault, these two assault platoons, which are now going into this objective, which I have bombarded with heavy mortars earlier. They are also supported by tanks. And I hope that if I have these two objectives, I will already win. Simply because this one is worth more than the others, and this one is normal. Now, this this company is not all that depleted. They're actually mostly intact. Look at this. Nice stuff. So, these I can push a bit harder. So, I might go for the bridge. I mean, I will obviously now with the tank here, I will take out these positions. I know there's Germans in here, but as soon as I have this, I can move tanks into there and relatively easily get that. Problem is, there's still a Jagdpanzer back here. And how can I take that out? I could theoretically try to go for the hat trick with this one. Move around here, maybe? But it's pretty far away and it's also getting dark. As you can see here, it's almost 8 PM. So yeah, I'm not 100% sure, but just so yeah, so the overview right now is kill these people, then maybe pull back the tank for now and rest here. Not do anything here for now. Capture this farm and then maybe push onto here, depending on how the situation develops. that's the plan. Sorry for this long technical overview, but this scenario kind of escalated a bit. I'm not under fire here at all, so if there were Germans in this hedge line, the mortars flushed them out. Running through this terrain really tires them out, but I want to get into this. You might remember that I bombed this in the beginning. Apparently erroneously, because I don't see any anti-tank guns as I had suspected, so okay. Ah, shit. My tank spotted the Jagdpanzer. Well, at least so far it doesn't shoot back. Question is, let's say I hit it with the 75. Will that destroy it? Nope. So I would push up the Firefly, maybe try to get it. And... yeah, okay, the 75 doesn't go through. Although it seems possible to cause armor spalling, because these late war German vehicles have very low armor quality. But yeah, I'm moving up the Firefly. Although that is one hell of a shot to make. I popped out the tank commander because it seems relatively safe here. Doesn't spot yet though, only the 75. Wonder if the visibility is already too low. Ah, God, they're gonna be so powered out after going through that swamp. Now, what was going on up here? I heard some firing. More SS dudes with a death wish, but I'm gonna pull back the tank. No, first kill these guys, then I'm gonna pull you back. Okay, I told them to get onto this area here because it seems relatively safe. Huh, I'm just not getting through that Jagdpanzer. Not the way I fear. Another SS dude, huh? Yeah, retreat. The Firefly does not spot that thing. So I have to move him up here. Basically switch places. Oh, there was a machine gun. Okay, apparently there still is some resistance here. Oh, got him though. Huh. Okay, this guy will retreat a bit. Ah, they keep slipping into these inundated areas. I mean, I guess technically there's no cover there, but...
King David! Go, go, go!
Back. Okay, they surrendered. I think this objective will be mine very, very soon. Mud or not. They're still doing stuff over here from time to time. Retreating? Yeah. Firefly. That's not the Firefly. Okay. The spotting contact is a bit brighter, so it is spotting it slowly. Why? Oh well. Ah, I forgot to move up the fire support elements. I can move them into here as well. Put them up here. Maybe then I can use them to suppress this. Although, to be honest, I'm running out of time a bit. And I don't want to make mistakes now. Although these Germans seem very easily suppressed, so they're probably broken. Okay, let's start this. Or rather, let's end this. No casualty? No? Okay, good. Nice. Okay. Oh, Firefly spotted it. No hit. It might have spotted me as well, though. Eh, not good. Problem. We found another Jagdpanzer over here. No, wait, that one's not out. Where is it? Over here, yeah. Sorry. So yeah, they have a lot of... actually, that's cool. Ah, shit, it's shooting at my infantry too. So... let's see if Mr. Richmond can take care of it. It's dark, huh? Okay, the Firefly is hitting that one. Ah, it disappeared. Will we make the hat trick? That is the question. Oh shit, it saw us first. We're screwed. Not Sergeant Richmond! Damn it. Well, it's only a partial penetration. Tracks are a bit damaged. Can we get around the corner is the question. Nope. No, but nobody died. Okay, at least that is something. But if... fuck. Yeah, okay. He didn't make the hat trick. Come on, get out of there. Of course, maybe if I get a new tank, you know, for him, I can use him again. I mean, he's pretty good. Plus one. So, I've hit these, this one several times, did some penetrations, and I think it might be empty. It hasn't moved at all. Because of that, I kind of want to take revenge for Richmond's tank. So I'm gonna rush the Shermans in support here into the compound, to this hatch. So, let's clear out the last of the Germans here. Although I think most of them are just surrendering.
Da drüben, feindliche Infanterie!
Now, over here. I still have some tanks in reserve that I will try to get on the Jagdpanzer to avenge Mr. Richmond here. Where is he? Is that the crew? Yeah. Whenever I hear Richmond, I picture the guy from the IT Crowd, you know, the goth guy. I don't know. That's a hard shot to make.
Keep moving! Go, go, go!
Enemy troops ahead!
Yep, that objective is mine. Don't think the tanks are spotting this one yet, though. Damn it. Some more.
Zug!
Drop it! Hands up!
Komm raus, nicht schießen!
Nifty. Problem is, I can't directly move tanks into here because this ditch here apparently is uncrossable. Nice. Problem is, I'm not spotting the Jagdpanzer. Maybe I will call in artillery, but I don't think that will arrive quickly enough. So it might be that we can't get this one. Now that Richmond's tank is destroyed, I don't necessarily want to attack from here either, with the depleted infantry, but who, no armor support. So... No, I'm not spotting that. I might just run the clock down to the end of the scenario. Maybe we'll spot it and destroy it at some point or not. But I don't really want to do much more now with only 8 minutes left. I could try to get to this, but it seems hard. Especially because I can't easily maneuver the tanks around here without drawing fire from the Jagdpanzer. And I'm pretty sure I've won anyway. And I did run the clock down a bit, but, okay. Yeah, it's a major attack brewing, apparently. And I don't have a tank on this side to do anything about it. So I need to get away from the hedge for now. Damn it. told them to hide for now. If it does come closer, we do have a pier somewhere here. I think the Germans are reinforcing this objective. Still, this is a weird turn of events this close before the end of the scenario. Generally speaking, I really like this scenario because it just kept escalating, like there's always something new happening. I mean, it started very slow because you only had the armored cars, but after that it got crazier and crazier. And the last minute was ticking down. That guy is so unlucky that he got hit this close to the end. So yeah, I'm expecting a tactical victory or a minor victory or whatever it's called. I'm kind of pissed I couldn't get this one, especially because it knocked out our good tank. That was unfortunate. So, that was the first day of Operation Market Garden. Well, it went relatively well. I won most of the scenarios, except the stupid bugged one. And let's see what happens in this one. And there's the sun sets. I hope I get some reinforcements because this platoon is fucked up. And I ceasefired at the end. So, got two of those objectives, one which is worth double the points. Casualties and condition were fine. They had the other two, obviously. And casualties and enemy condition, they failed. Lost 2 men killed, 13 men wounded, 1 tank, and 1 armored car. They lost 64 men killed, 43 wounded, 12 men captured, and lost 2 Jagdpanzers. Let's see. So, well, 9 enemy casualties, but these, look at this platoon, it's like, well, okay, they belong to them, so this is one squad, but still. So, these are the rest of the Fallschirmjäger. That's one of the crew. And so, what was this force attacking here now? That's this one. Oh, look at this. It's total campaign victory, so they have that in more than one scenario? Interesting. I didn't know that it could also happen with the AI, but it makes sense, I guess. Same with these guys. These SS dudes. Now, was that also the case for these assholes here? Yep. Nice. So, there's one SS platoon that we don't have to worry about in some later scenario. Oh, and what about these? Okay. Yeah, same here. So, this guy is called Deelchurk. Wait, isn't that the name of the... That is weird. But yeah, okay, so the Deelchurk guy. We have his number, we will get our revenge on him in some later scenario, I guess. Yeah, these are all nice and fucked up, so we might not have to worry about them. Here's the tank destroyer that we bombarded for ages, also in the campaign later. Ah, we knocked out the main gun, that's why it was so quiet. That's good to know. So we have two Jagdpanzers less. I'm guessing those were also campaign units. Wait, where were they? Yeah, knocked out. So two less to worry about and one that has a fucked up gun. I don't know if it gets repaired between the scenarios, but that would be nice if we had basically three less Jagdpanzers in one of the later ones. These were just chilling here, I guess. SS dudes that are also in the campaign. I think I might also understand what this weird suicidal charge here was about. I think they were scripted to retreat. And that's why they did that. And probably the idea of the scenario is that you can inflict casualties on these SS guys that come in later, but they try to evade. And if you do inflict the casualties, you actually get, you know, an easier time in later scenarios. I think that was the point of this. So yeah, as I said, pretty nice scenario. Let's see, wait, where's Richmond? That's him. Yeah, two Panzer IV mid, one flak. These guys didn't knock out much in this one. Yeah, okay, I don't want to look at all of these now. Maybe here. Yeah. So, yeah, anyway, that was this scenario. Hope you enjoyed it. As always, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.